Zella's eyes filled with tears.
"Must I give up my pretty shoes, then?"
she asked.
"They are the only ones I have ever owned."
Inga was sorry for the poor girl, but he knew how important it was that he regain possession of the magic pearls. So he said pleadingly, "Please let me have them, Zella. See, I will exchange for them the shoes I now have on, which are newer and prettier than the others." The girl hesitated. She wanted to please the boy prince, yet she hated to exchange the shoes which her father had brought her as a present. "If you will give me the shoes," continued the boy anxiously, "I will promise to make you and your father and mother rich and prosperous. Indeed, I will promise to grant any favors you may ask of me." And he sat down upon the floor and drew off the shoes he was wearing and held them toward the girl. "I'll see if they will fit me," said Zella, taking off her left shoe, the one that contained the pink pearl, and beginning to put on one of Inga's. Just then Queen Cor, angry at being made to wait for her whip with the seven lashes, rushed into the room to find Inga. Seeing the boy sitting upon the floor beside Zella, the woman sprang toward him to beat him with her clenched fists. But Inga had now slipped on the shoe, and the queen's blows could not reach his body. Then Cor espied the whip lying beside Inga, and snatching it up, she tried to lash him with it, all to no avail. While Zella sat horrified by this scene, the prince, who realized he had no time to waste, reached out and pulled the right shoe from the girl's foot, quickly placing it upon his own. Then he stood up and, facing the furious but astonished queen, said to her in a quiet voice, "Madam, please give me that whip."
"I won't," answered Cor. "I'm going to lash those Pingaree women with it."
The boy seized hold of the whip and, with irresistible strength, drew it from the queen's hand. But she drew from her bosom a sharp dagger and, with the swiftness of lightning, aimed a blow at Inga's heart. He merely stood still and smiled, for the blade rebounded and fell clattering to the floor.